The Persian Gulf embraces a torn piece of land in the shape of a fish, the jewel every Iranian is proud of, Qeshm Island. Qeshm Island is a wonderful gallery of geological phenomena and biological diversity covering an area of about 1,600 square kilometers. The formation of Namekton Salt Dome on the southwest coast of the island has created a rare collection of geological phenomena. Outcrops of rock and various ores, salt compounds in an array of different colors, hematite salt springs and salt caves are typical features of this salt dome. Cradling the biggest salt cave in the world, reaching 6 kilometers in length, the Namekton Salt Dome on Qeshm Island enjoy world fame. Due to the saline formations around the salt dome, the flowing waters are not potable. But to the north of Namekton Dome and its vicinity, islanders have dug some wells in the wonderful formations of Chaku Gorge in order to collect and store the rainwater. As Qeshm Island is located in a hot and dry region, residents have developed innovative methods to collect and store the precious seasonal rains. In addition to the local water reservoirs, a novel method was invented in the past in Loft Village, in which 366 wells, equal to the number of the days in a leap year, had been dug into the impenetrable marl and clay formations. Having the walls all filled up with water during the winter season, they would seal up the walls to be opened one by one with the revolution of each new day for people to use the water. The islanders therefore had water stored and allocated for a whole year. These wells used to be called tala or talab. The existence of so many dams in the island, some of which date back to Sassanid period, tells the story of the Qeshm people's acquired expertise and strong will in adapting themselves to their environment. At a few points on the island, there are small pools of underground freshwater. At these places, the islanders grow vegetables and summer crops in the island. These wonderful gardens are among the many interesting practices of the islanders. Water plays a significant role in coastal erosion, resulting in a wide variety of attractive forms and shapes. The most graceful examples of this phenomenon can be seen in the Valley of Stars. The coating of specular iron or alligist over the ripple sands on the south coasts have turned this part of the island into a silvery, shiny sheet. The sea surrounding Qeshm is the home to so many species of plants and animals, as well as coral reefs. No trace of traditional pearl hunting is seen today, yet the pearl oyster farms are being developed in the southern part. Two rare and endangered species of sea turtle migrate to the south coast of Qeshm Island to lay their eggs, the green turtle and the hawksbill turtle. Support provided by the Qeshm Ecosystem and Environmental Management Group, along with local training, has led to increased cooperation in protecting these species of turtles. Qeshm's old sedimentary terraces hold some ancient man-made caves in different periods in the past. Kharbaz caves have been used as places of refuge and of worship for people. In addition to tallow wells, the historic village of Loft is home to a graceful celebration of traditional architecture, featuring beautiful wind catchers whose architecture is totally unique in Iran. In the vicinity of Loft lies the sea forest of Hara with the area of 200 square kilometers, a forest of mangrove trees. This species is called Avicenna. Hara Forest is one of the few biosphere reserves in the world. A majority of the over 300 species of migratory and native birds of Qeshm live in this forest. Traditional boatyards are still in operation on Qeshm. This profession is a legacy of the past. Today, the boats are used for carrying passengers and cargo, as well as fishing. In Qeshm, women are involved in local handcrafts. There are dozens of mosques of various sizes. People in Qeshm are pious, patient, and warm-hearted. From the remote past, fishing has been the main profession of most islanders, and today, traditional and industrial fishing hold central importance. After carrying out preliminary studies, the Geological Survey of Iran suggested the establishment of a geopark in Qeshm in 2002. From 2004 to 2006, through scientific collaboration with GSI, the Qeshm Free Zone organization worked on providing the necessary documentation for the UNESCO Global Geopark Network. At last, the Qeshm Geopark, with an area of 30,000 acres, became registered in the UNESCO's list of world geoparks, placing Iran among the 17 nations with geoparks. Qeshm is the first geopark in the Middle East and one of only 53 in the world. The unique geological formations, the spectacular scenery, and the rich biological diversity of Qeshm Island are all heavenly blessings entrusted to us. The arduous path of recognition, introduction, and registration of Qeshm Geopark has been traversed. Now the more difficult path is that of preservation and development, which still lies ahead. public cooperation and support provided by officials, as well as adopting correct policies, shall open a new horizon for the island's future.